What's up, school fans? Welcome back to Trash Talk. Back with me, Rocky Padilla, and today we have USC, Houston University, Southern California, assistant coach Eric Mobley with me. This is a very special day. How you doing, coach?
I'm doing great. How about yourself?
I'm good. Thank you so much for joining me, taking your time off from your busy schedule. I really appreciate it.
No problem.
And do you remember anything about this? Hold on, I'm gonna show you something. Hopefully you can see it.
Yeah.
What's that, number 15?
Yeah. Wow, do you have that? Wow.
You
gotta send that to me.
I will. Oh. So I'm very lucky. When I was small, I used to record.
Send that to me.
Yes, when I was small, I used to record a lot of your games. Actually, this is 94.
Uh-huh.
We're playing with Indonesia Muda in Kobatama.
Yes.
I just want to ask you, like, what can you remember from that experience?
Man, that was wonderful, man. Just to be in Jakarta and playing for Indonesia Muda, that was fun. Great experience. Had some great guys on the team. A good coach, you know, who ran the mess out of me because I came there out of shape. I had a bum, I believe, right ankle injury that, you know, you guys were able to heal it, and I was able just to play and have a good time. It was a great experience.
Of course, that's a good story. And of course, I want to say congratulations, your boy Evan Mobley today declares for NBA draft.
Right.
How excited are you for his future and his new journey?
Man, I'm so super proud of him. Mm-hmm. You know, and both boys, just super proud of them. And you know, I just words can't describe how excited I am about them and their future. And you know, it's all about just doing the right things, and now they've been blessed, so we're happy about that.
Before we talk further about the NBA draft process, I would like to ask you, you guys have a deep run in the NCAA tournament, and then you and Evan and Isaiah, just as a family, you know, experience this special moment, I think, with the NCAA tournament. Man, can you describe the experience with the boys?
That's another thing that is words can't describe, because you know, you're there with your family, you're with your two boys. You know, it's not that many people that are able to get in that position and coach them, and also coach them at a young age, and then coach them in college, and then get to the point where we got to the Elite Eight, and just us doing what we did, you know, this year. We never expected it. We had some high expectation in terms of goals and all that. But at the end of the day, I mean, to just go to the Elite Eight and them doing what they did, I mean, it's amazing.
I mean, like, you guys put USC back on the map. It's been a while since they went to the tournament, you know. So just what do you like about that, about your team this season?
You know, our team is some good kids. We have some great, great kids. Mm-hmm. And some great parents, and it starts with that first. And you know, these guys worked their tail off, you know, during this pandemic. You know, it's been tough, you know, just not having a gym, you know, because California, you know, pretty much shut down. And so we had to practice on a blacktop, and some days where it's really hot outside, and we practice, and you know, we did what we had to do, you know, run the track and all that stuff. And the guys, they just gel together, and we just came together and we did what we did this year, so it was awesome.
And this is really interesting though, you're an assistant coach for your boys, and you're talking about as a parent, how do you differentiate that at home, you know, as a parent and as a coach, you know?
Sometimes it's difficult, you know. Sometimes, you know, you have to deal with guys, you know, like, hey, you gotta take out the trash versus, you know, hey, let's go to the gym. And so you know, at a young age, that used to be very tough for them to take me as a coach, and you know, I'm yelling at them on the court, and then turn around, we go home, and hey, can you take the trash out? And so, but they learn over time, you know, to adjust, and it's been great.
Obviously, Evan and Isaiah put in a lot of work to get on this point, you know.
Right.
But I would like to know though, what kind of sacrifices did they make to get to this point?
Well, I mean, it starts with my wife and I. We, you know, I was working a corporate job and making good money. And in 2012, I, you know, decided to go full time and start my own program, and where the kids can play every position, from guard to power, you know, power forward to center. So they learn all five positions. And then, being that I played basketball at a college, and you know, play professionally overseas. I just poured in what I know. My wife, she also played high school and had a chance to get a scholarship for basketball. And so she poured in with her knowledge, and it was a good combination. And so they are where they are now. So we worked a lot. It's been many times been in the gym late nights and, you know, in the backyard and a lot of, you know, bickering and fighting between the two. But we're here. So we're blessed.
How was that backyard battle, though, between Isaiah and Evan? Actually, they're almost at the same size, right?
Yeah.
So how was that battle? Is there any good story about it?
You know, I mean, sometimes, you know, Evan was getting beat down pretty bad because Isaiah was bigger and stronger and faster, and Evan was still developing as a skinny kid, you know, slim kid, and he had to work his tail off, and brother would beat up on him and beat him every time. So Evan would push him at times, so I had to like separate the two and have one come inside, and so it was a lot of battles in that backyard.
But Evan seems like a very quiet guy. But I'm wondering, because my segment is called Trash Talk, I would like to know, does he talk trash on the court?
He screams. He screams a lot. So if you notice all his dunks, he screams.
Yeah, I do.
And that's old school, you know. Back in the day, we used to scream and holler when he dunked the ball. Uh-huh. So he does a lot of that. Guys talk trash to him, and he ignores it, and then he just dunks on them every time. So his trash talking is on the court and in his play. So that's what he does.
What about that dunk, though, against Oregon?
Yeah.
That was your reaction, probably.
Yeah.
On the side, watching that dunk.
You know, it's hard to keep your composure, you know, as a dad, as a coach on the bench. And, you know, you get excited about certain plays they make, and you just try to just keep it all in. But it's hard at times, you know. Sometimes you get excited, and sometimes you just try to be well-mannered and respectful. So
let's talk about Isaiah. He's a 6'10", three-pointer. How he got his shooting, though, you know, because he's a big man.
Yeah.
He's very versatile on the court. So how did he work on his game?
Well, you know, we shoot a lot, number one. Two, it starts at a young age, you know. They started playing on a perimeter at a young age, because when I played, you know, even though I played the four spot, I was able to dribble the ball and do a lot of skill work, with the ball. So what we did is with them is at a young age, the first thing I taught them was how to dribble, you know. So young people out there, first thing to learn is how to dribble first. You know, that's the key. Learn how to dribble first, and then the second thing is learn how to shoot. So we did a lot of the ball handling first, and then we built from that to shooting.
Thank you so much, though, for sharing that. Because in Indonesia, actually, the most important thing they need to learn is fundamentals.
Yes.
People now skip fundamentals because they see Steph Curry, they see Kyrie Irving, they just want those handles, you know. But of course, can you talk about how important fundamental is for everybody?
Fundamentals is very, very important. I was coached by a lot of good coaches when I was in high school and when I got to college, and all they taught me was fundamentals. So I started with my boys with fundamentals. First of all, I never let them shoot three-pointers until I got at least about, I would say 11, 12, 13, because I didn't want them to heave the ball.
Okay.
Heave the ball. And we were working more on form shooting, hand placement on the ball, and just good form when they shoot. So that's all the things that we worked on, and I never allowed them to shoot three-pointers. And if they did it on their own. So in a game, no three-pointers until they got to a certain age.
But now Bo can shoot three-pointers really good.
Yes.
And Evan, when I saw his interview, he always said Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
What do you think he can learn from Kevin Durant preparing himself going to the NBA?
Yeah, just quiet as kept, you know. Evan can do just about what he can do in terms of like Kevin Durant. He can play just as like him. He just that when a system that requires that he plays in the four and five spot. Evan can play the perimeter. All his life he's been playing five-out motion, so he's good at five-out motion. It's just that certain coaches haven't seen that. And plus, in America, you have to play a certain way to get wins. So,
true.
Yeah.
So now we're gonna talk about the draft process. We know it's still the pandemic. I'm just wondering, is the draft process is still gonna be the same like usual, or is it gonna be different?
To what I'm understanding, that is gonna be the normal of going through the whole draft process of to summer league and all those things. So what I'm hearing is supposed to be back to normal.
Wow, that's nice though if they're gonna have summer league again. It's like one of the most fun time of the year. But I'm curious too, how are you gonna prepare Evan to be ready for this draft process?
Well, you know, I'm letting him have his little vacation.
In Houston now, that's why they're not here.
Right. So they're on vacation right now, and so they're going to do that. And then when they get back, we'll start with conditioning first, getting them in shape, and then you build from there. So it's all about conditioning first, and then you go from there. So we'll probably end up doing the first week once a day, and then as time goes on, we'll go twice a day, and then three times a day.
Wow, three times a day?
Yeah, three times a day.
How do you weigh out three times a day?
Well, you start with weights in the morning, and this is not a set routine right now, but in my mind, this is what I have, you know, and that's weights first, get some shots up. After you lift weights, and that's important to do that, after you lift, keep your touch, and then come back at noontime, get up a bunch of shots, and then in the evening, skill work.
Okay, how many shots usually?
Usually in one day?
Yeah, 200, 300?
You know, in between classes with my kids, we put up some shots, about 30 minutes of shooting, you know, in between classes and get back to class. Okay. So if they have a class at 8 o'clock, they'll come to the gym, shoot for 30 to 45 minutes, and then go to class. And then we go to practice at 2:30. So it's a lot of shots. In order to be successful, you know, I truly believe in the rule of thumb is that, you know, you got to put up 10,000 shots. You know, you got to do something 10,000 times to be great at it. So I really believe in just repetition.
That's good. That's a good insight for all the coaches in Indonesia. Right. Because, you know, I think all the coaches in Indonesia, they need a lot of new knowledge. Because a lot of old school head coaches, no disrespect.
Right.
Old school head coaches are great too. But the game is evolving right now.
Yes, it is.
It's so different from the 90s. So what do you think is the game? What differentiate the game from the 90s to now?
Well, you know, back when I played, it was a lot of physicality. Mm-hmm. And now it's more a finesse game where you can't hand check. You know, I used to hand check back in the day. So, it's more, you got to have skills. You got to be able to put the ball on the floor. You got to be able to shoot. You got to be able to, you know, triple threat, dribble pass, all that stuff. So those are the things that I worked on with my sons since they were babies.
And I'm very interested. I saw your bio on the USC team. It says you're a foster parent.
Yes.
How do you get into that? And I think that is an amazing thing to do. I really admire that. That's right. I want you to talk about it.
Well, I'll start with my mom. My mom adopted some kids in our home when we graduated and went to college. And I watched her raise them as good young men. And so I just took her philosophy. I mean, we always had somebody in our house, either my friends or some neighborhood kids, and she was always feeding them. So I just took that, you know, what she did with those kids, and I just started opening up my door. You know, like, you know, my house was the house where everyone came to play basketball or play video games. I had everything at my house, the backyard, swimming pool, all that stuff. So they were able to do those things. And so Johnny, who we call Johnny Mobley, he's a Chinese kid.
Yeah, that's what I saw.
Yeah, who attends Rancho Christian. I was a coach over there, and one day he asked, you know, can he live with us? And he's good friends with my sons, and he comes over, and, you know, I said, why not, you know? So, you know, he's a good kid, and, you know, he inquired to go to college, and he likes hanging out with my boys, and he likes basketball, and so we had some things in common, and it's like, no, you know, come on over.
Does he play?
Yes, he plays.
He plays for the varsity team?
No. But he played for the high school team at Rancho Christian.
Okay, that's really nice.
Johnny Liu.
Yeah, that's why when I saw your bio, I was like, oh, this is a very good story.
Yes.
And last one, before I let you leave, what are the keys to raise two boys? the keys of raising two boys.
You know, you just teach them.
They're really great boys, man.
Appreciate it.
Very humble, very... I saw all the interviews, really, really nice people.
Yeah. I think, you know, it starts with just love, you know, just love, showing them love, kindness, you know, showing them kindness, and just, you know, just the ability to have a diverse mindset about things. And life is bigger than just basketball. You know, there's other people around, you know, like as they were growing up, you know, I would show them certain things in terms of courtesy. Like when the janitor will open up the gym, even though he's a janitor, you still give him respect. You still say, how are you doing? How's everything going? You know, and that just rubs off. You know, as I did it, I think they saw it, and their mom being kind, she's a teacher, she was able to share those things. And so they just learned to be kind and nice, and you know, and it also start with, you know, going to church. You know, we go to church, we church folks. You know, I'm not the best Christian, you know, guys still working with me, but you know, you know, that helps a lot too. So just being around good, positive people.
Wow, that's really good.
Yeah.
So coach, thank you so much for taking your time off and
yes.
doing this interview with me. I really appreciate it.
No problem.
Because you know, he doesn't know me, but he said yes to this interview, so that
yeah.
was really amazing. Yeah. Hopefully next time we're gonna get your boys too
okay.
to do some interviews. So
okay.
once again, congratulations
thank
and
you.
Good luck
okay.
with everything. Good
yes.
luck with Evan and Isaiah and also your family and of course USC next season.
All right.
Go Trojans.
Okay. Fight on.
Yeah, because my sister also went to USC for her bachelor and master degree. Actually, my father-in-law.
Uh-huh.
My father-in-law, is he went to USC too in the
80s. Awesome.
Yeah,
awesome,
so that's really awesome. So
yeah,
once
yeah.
again, thank you so much
yes.
for your time.
And shout out to Indonesia Muda.
Indonesia Muda, yeah.
Indonesia Muda.
He wants
yeah.
to go back to Bali, he said.
Yeah, he wants to go to Bali, that's it.
Yeah,
that's
Bali is super nice. So.
Awesome.
Thank you guys for watching. Yeah. Don't forget to like and don't forget to comment. And of course, support USC next season. And I really appreciate you guys for watching. And we'll see you guys next video. Peace. All right.